kidneys, how to fold the kidneys in anatomical position. First of all, you have to see upper pole is broad, lower pole is narrow. You can see upper pole is broad and lower pole is narrow. Then you can see medial border is convex, so concavo-convex, and lateral border is convex. The anterior surface is more convex and irregular, whereas posterior surface is more or less flat. You can compare this with a couple who are sitting together and dreaming for a long term future. Okay, so heads are like this, upper pole nearer, lower pole away. So in the face, upper pole broad, lower pole chin is narrow. Anteriorly it is irregular and more convex. Posteriorly it is more or less flat. And among those couple, you will see always one head is slightly higher than the other. So here left kidney is slightly higher than the
right kidney.
Now during practical, what you have to understand, you have to understand one point is very important, that is this ureter should be posterior. And directed downward. So this is how to hold kidneys in anatomical position. Weight grossly 1/360 part of the body. 1/360 part of the body weight. So in female, average weight is lesser. So in female, average kidney weight is 135 grams. In male, average male weight is higher, so it is 150 grams. Length is 11 centimeters. Width 6 centimeters. Thickness is
3 centimeters.
So there is a geometrical progress. 150 into 2, 300 of that. So 300, if you take millimeter, 3 centimeter. So thickness, then 6 centimeter. Again, multiplied to 6 centimeter is the width, and 12, just less than 12, 11 centimeter is the length. Now, coming to the its relation. First of all, it is retroperitoneal, so posterior surface don't have any peritoneal relation, and anteriorly some parts are peritoneal. Apart from peritoneum, it has got 4 layers of covering. First of all, this is true capsule, that is renal capsule. After that, there is a perinephric fat. After perinephric fat, there is a renal fascia, and beyond renal fascia, there is paranephric fat. So these are the 4 layers of covering. After these 4 layers of covering, anteriorly, there are, in right kidney, there are 5 relation and impression for that. What are the right 5 things? Here there is right suprarenal gland, so that is right suprarenal area. Then here there is liver, that is hepatic area. Then there is second part of duodenum, that is duodenal area. Then there is right colic flexure, that is colic area, and jejunum. So these are the 5 relation and impression. Whichever is related, they will create some impression. So adrenal gland will create adrenal area. Liver will create hepatic area. Second part of duodenum will create duodenal area. Right colic flexure will create colic area. And jejuna will create jejunal area. So the 5 areas created by 5 anterior relations. Coming to the left kidney. Left kidney, you can see similarly, very much similar to right side, suprarenal gland, here also suprarenal gland, here also
suprarenal gland.
Right hypochondrium of the abdomen, there is situation of liver. In left hypochondrium of the abdomen, situation stomach and spleen. So instead of hepatic area, there will be gastric area and splenic area, because it is related to stomach and spleen, which is situated at left hypochondrium. Now, from duodenum up to spleen, there is a horizontal structure, horizontal organ, that is pancreas. So that pancreas, here there is splenic area and here there is duodenal area. That pancreas is situated below gastric and splenic area, that is pancreatic area, related to body and tail of pancreas. And here there is jejunal area and left colic flexure. Why so? Because left kidney is slightly higher than the right kidney. So jejunum will be at the same level, and this transverse colon is not straight, not exactly horizontal. Transverse colon, one side is lower and one side is higher. So that is why here above colic area, below jejunal area. But here above jejunal area,
below colic area.
So here there are six structures related and six areas.